Doing some wire loom action right now for the rear lines. The last two lines. I just finished up zip tying this shit. All nice. So I woke up at about 7. Started working on the car about 7:30. I finished up the rear struts on my car. Put in the stock ones. Stock height right now, baby. I took out the front ones. The right front is leaking some oil, so the shock might be blown. But we're just gonna go with it anyways. Pretty simple, just take out the 19 on the bottom and the 3 top hat bolts, just like the rear. Looking like a Lexus dealership over here. I finished zip tying this front one too. It out. Oh yeah. Damn, gotta get some flush cuts, man. These zip ties are sharp. So we're just gonna continue running the rear lines, cleaning everything up. That way you can start putting the panels back and then plumbing everything and doing all the electrical in the back. Hopefully we get it done by today, yeah. We have to go get some more stuff at Napa. And we ate some, I guess, breakfast at Arby's. So, back to work. Gonna run the airline to one of these grommets.
ABS.
This ABS one right there. It comes out right here. The hole's right there. Goes to the bag. So, pretty much done with this side. They're doing the other side right now. Same process. Still a mess, but we're gonna have to clean it up. So we'll check back soon. I think this is good enough, huh? Hopefully the retractor goes on. Alright, they're working on pulling the other side through. Probably gotta take out the wheel. Just the situation in the back right now. Still gotta wire up the compressors. I mean, almost there. Just cleaning everything up. So, I don't know, we'll see. I don't know how long. All right, Liddell finished plumbing this side up. Running it through the ABS wire on this side. Now I just gotta clean it up and zip tie it. Zip tie all this bullshit. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Alright, so some guys they zip tie it like this and they don't, but it looks a lot cleaner when you do. You gotta take pride in your work. So now Liddell is wiring up the compressors back there, soldering them up. You can use butt connectors if you want, but like I said, it's a little bit better to solder. Takes a lot longer, but in the long run, it's a little bit better. It looks cleaner and it's a better connection when you have solder versus butt connectors. Every time you run the airlines, you're gonna wanna route it so there's less chances of it being pierced or cut. And less chances of it getting kinked, because you don't want that to happen or else you're gonna be a lot of pain. So take some time to survey the car and see where it would be best to route the lines. Just finished zip tying this side. Now, what's next? I think the back. That's the main part now. Then after we get all the back wired up and cleaned up, then we go to the struts. Just gotta do the front, connect the rears, put all the panels back on the inside, then hopefully everything goes smoothly. we didn't forget anything. But yeah, check this shit out. Damn son, that's some A1 fucking wiring. Soldering 101, guys. Alright, we out here soldering now. That's all you need right here. Solder and soldering iron. Alright, it's about 2:15. Still going at it. We got the back down. I think the back is pretty much done. Not the lines and everything, just the suspension part. Routed all the airline to the struts. Now we're taking care of the front. I got the stock strut out and the airlift strut in. Oh yeah. So now we gotta route the airline to the front. I'm gonna go through this ABS grommet right here. No ABS, or actually this is like the height sensor wiring. Attach it to that. They're all taking care of the compressor wiring. The wiring specialist. Still going at it. It looks like a hot mess right now, but it'll be clean in about a couple hours, so we'll see. Taking a break because I'm fucking kind of tired already. We got the left front driver's side strut in, airline plumb. Just gotta tighten down all the nuts and bolts, and then that one's ready to freaking go. And we gotta do the other side though. I think Ludo's wrapping up this setup. Is it tight? Your fit? There it is. Now I know how this shit comes out. So the other side, I hope, is gonna go a little bit quicker. Back to work. Alright, we out here doing this shit. First thing gotta take off is this speed sensor separated from this knuckle. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Then crack this upper control arm. Fuck. Let's see the fucking slip. Don't want to loosen it all the way yet.
Make sure it's, you know, reaching.
Now we're gonna go ahead and loosen the lower strut bolt. The nut side is a 19 and the bolt side is a 17 millimeter. Good thing we got this half inch impact. Oh shit. Get that bolt out. Next, you gotta take out the sway bar. It's a 17 millimeter. Oh yeah! Sometimes you gotta lay down. Too old for this already. Now, take out this upper control arm nut. Usually you can whack this with a hammer, it'll come right out. Well, let's try it that way real quick. Alright, here we go. Alright, we just gotta use a special tool.
Okay.
See right here? That's why we need the zip ties. You don't wanna have slack or have tension on this wire or the brake line. Else you're gonna have to replace the brake line. You just gotta get the top hat, the top mount bolts. That 14 mil. Alright, let's go up to the top.
Just give these bad boys a bit of cracking.
Fill up the battery ratchet.
minus the ignition.
Time to take this bitch out.
But that's it.
Got this bitch out.
Christopher, please. All right, now guys, we're checking the clearance of the airline when the bag goes up and down. It's a very crucial part of the install. Or else you'll be left with the left front down on the side of the road and you can't air it up. You don't want that to happen. Then you gotta spend money on a tow truck or work on the side of the road, and that's not always a pleasant thing to do. So we're getting there. I only like doing installs like this when you're making good progress. When you're stuck, then it's a pain in the ass. Then you wanna give up.
And you're like, fuck.
Last night was rough, man. Felt like we were getting nowhere, especially when everybody's over here just fucking talking story, and then you don't work, and fuck this. People making you take shots and shit. Pretty much the right front is done. We gotta do the power, the ground, and the ignition. Wire all that up. And then, hopefully there's no leaks in the rear, the trunk setup. Hopefully all the fittings are sealed good. Hopefully all the panels go back easily as they came off. And that's it.
All right, it's good.
All right, clearance checks out. Now put on the wheel and work on the powers and grounds. Yeah, check out that wheel gap, bro. All right, these are the power wires for the management and the compressors. We gotta put some fuses for protection. Gotta cut this bad boy to the correct length and then solder it in there. I'd rather be in the Philippines right now. We'll be out here bagging cars. I don't fuck with bags, baby. Static all day. Just kidding. Measure twice, cut once. You don't want to cut it too short, then you're fucked, then you gotta solder another wire on. Alright folks, we got the main power wire on. It's gonna hook up to your battery like this. The them are working on the signal, or the, what is it called? Ignition wire. Oh, never mind, they're done. Doing the airlines. You know what I'm saying? Plugging that bitch in. About to air this bitch up. Let's make them dump out over there behind the stuff, huh? Alright, we're about to fire it up. Fingers crossed. So, oh, we got power. We gotta program everything.
Start them up.
All right, so far, so good. Everything working, I guess, so that's a good sign. How many cut out?
Because it's doing a test. And after when it stopped, it's showing that a low pressure.
Oh, I see. All right, it's calibrating. I'm done. All right, so far, seems all right.
Well, not that far.
All right, we're just figuring out the setup, getting all the specs dialed in. So I gotta set like ride height and everything. Setting the max pressure for the tank and shit. So the compressor cuts out at about 150 or whatever it is. Just for pressing the air out for the first time. I'm done. Bag life, bros. Alright, we're putting all the panels back together in the seats. There's one downside. There's a leak somewhere, so we gotta find that. Other than that, everything works pretty legit. Hopefully stays that way. After we find that leak, hopefully that's it. So, for now, put back all the panels. It took us about, I think we worked on it 3 hours the first day to set everything up, the setup. about 4 or 5 hours the second night. And then today it was about, say, 5 or 6 hours. So it was about a day and a half, 2 days to bag this thing from zero to hero. Swap out the struts from my car, but I didn't finish that yet, so I still
gotta keep it low key. We ain't gotta show ball, cause it can get messy as a hobo. And it's better that they don't know that we out doing our grown folk. Keep me warm all winter, cause it don't stop, girl. I love to get in ya. In the drop top, looking just like a winner. Hit me later on, boo, maybe we can get up. Yeah, hook it up like a tow truck. Later on, we can get it in like a slow cut. Hit a cool spot where them people don't know us. Then hit your G-spot while you scratching up my shoulders.
Ooh, girl, you a stunner. But baby girl, hit me on the under, or else my lady gon' wonder who calling my phone from this number.
I'ma keep it low key, I'ma keep it low key, I'ma keep it low key.
Gotta keep it low key.